Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Today, all of you will revise about the curve tool. So let us revise what you had learned in the last class. Do you remember which pictures you had made in the previous class? In the previous class, you made pictures of mountain, flag and a leaf. Look at the pictures in front of you and tell which one is that of the curve tool. From amongst the pictures being shown to you, the option B picture is that of the curve tool. Can you tell how many times you can bend the curve tool? The curve tool can be bent twice. But if needed, you may bend it only once also. If after making a drawing using the curve tool, we want to fill it with color, then which tool will you need to use? After making a drawing using the curve tool, we will use the fill with color option to fill colors in our picture. Now, all of you switch on your computer and open the paint file. In today's class, you will use the curve tool and make some more pictures like a scenery, fish, dolphin, a leaf which will have color inside it, bow and arrow, and some other drawings. Look at the picture being shown to you and tell what is this called. This is a picture of a scenery. Look at the picture being shown and tell if you can make it. You all will need to use the curve tool to make this picture. And then to fill it with color, you will use the fill with color option. Go ahead and show how you will make this picture. And in case of any problem, watch the video and learn from it. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the curve tool to make this colorful picture with colorful mountains, a colorful scenery. For that, we first need to select the rectangle tool. Select color 1 as black and then in the drawing area on the paint sheet, just drag a rectangle, a big rectangle, so that it covers your paint sheet. Now we need to draw the mountains in the scenery. So we select the curve tool and then by bringing a pointer inside the rectangle, we can drag our first curve or line here towards the bottom, horizontally across, and then we can bring the pointer here on the line and just drag the curve towards the top to make our mountain. If you like, you can click here and drag the curve downwards also. And then you can just click on the side so that this first mountain has been made. Next, let's make another small hill here by dragging a curve from here till this point on the rectangle. And then keeping the pointer on the line, on the curve, we can drag it upwards and then just click on the side so that the second hill or the second mountain is made on your paint sheet. Let's make another one on this side, on the left side. Drag a curve or a line from here till the second mountain. And then keeping the pointer on the line or on the curve, we can just keep our left button pressed and drag it upwards to make this third mountain. And then click on the side. Next, let's take another curve from here till the end of the rectangle, till one side of the rectangle. And then again, bring the pointer to this curve on this line and then drag it upwards. And then just left click once on the side. Let's make two more small hills on the left side of the rectangle. We'll make one line here using the curve tool. Click on the side and lift it from the center, dragging, and then just click there. Let's make another one here from this mountain to the last one that we have just drawn here. Join them and then bringing the pointer on this line, we just drag it upwards. So our mountains are made. Let's make the picture of a sun. So for that, you need to select the oval tool and then select both color 1 and color 2 as the dark yellow color or brownish color, both color 1 and color 2, so that it becomes a solid oval with that color. So we're keeping the same color there, and then here we can just drag an oval to make the sun. Let's make some blue lines are near the sun to make the sky. So let's change the color to blue, color 1. Let's choose the line tool, select the line tool, and then draw lines here to represent the sky. So we're just making a line here, another line here. We can make one more line like this by dragging. And let's make some lines on the other side of the sun also, here and here, and some on top of the mountains like this. One more. Now we need to fill the mountains with color so that our scenery appears colorful. So we select the fill with color option and then we change color 1 to brown color, and let's fill this here in the bottommost mountain. Change the color 1 by selecting a different color. This time we'll select red. We want to make colorful mountains in our scenery. So we are filling the red color here. Let's choose some different color, blue. We are making a very colorful picture. We are making this mountain as a blue mountain. Let's choose the green color now and fill this mountain with green. And then in the last two mountains on the top, let us fill the brown color. Dark brown color we have selected, and we fill it here like this. And this way you can use the curve tool to make this beautiful picture which is having many colorful mountains in it and the sun. Look at this picture in front of you and tell, what do we call it? This is a picture of a fish. Now look at this picture being shown to you and tell if you can make the same. Now make this picture, and in case of any doubt, watch the video to learn from it. Let us watch this video and learn how we can use the curve tool to make this picture of a fish. So to make this picture, you first need to select the curve tool, bring your pointer to the drawing area on your paint sheet, and then let's draw a line or a curve using the curve tool like this, a horizontal line, and then from here just left click on it and drag it upwards, double click it here on the side once so that you get the first curved line, which is the top of the fish. Now let's make another curved line or a line here as is being shown in the video, and then drag it downwards to make the bottom of the fish. Double click it here. Now let's make the tail fins of the fish. Here we draw a line slanting upwards. Since we are using a curve tool, it's actually a curve, and we can just place a pointer here and drag it upwards and then just double click it here. We make a similar line here at the bottom to make the lower fin of the tail. Bring the pointer to the middle and then drag it downwards like this. And then double click. Next, let's make another curve from here till and join it here to the top tail fin and drag it outwards and also drag it a little inside on the top like this as is being shown, and then just click on it. Similarly, at the bottom we make a line first, join these two ends, and then make a curve upwards and towards the bottom, just drag it a little inwards and then just double click and leave it there. Next, we have to make a curve here or a line here using the curve tool to make the mouth of the fish and then just double click it there. We are going to make the eyes also using the curve tool. So we just make a small line and drag it upwards to make the eye of the fish. And double click on it. We will next make inside the body of the fish. We will make a line or a curve here and then drag it like this and double click. Now we want to make a thin line as was in our original picture. So we select the thin size from the size option, click there, and then you can just make a curve or a line here towards the end, towards the tail of the fish, and then just double click here so that you get the center line of the fish. Now we have to make the side fins of the fish. So we need to erase some of the lines, so we can use the eraser tool. Select the eraser, bring the pointer here where you want to make the side fins and just erase a little portion from the top as well as from the bottom of the fish from here. Now, since we are again going to use the curve tool, we need to go back to the shapes and select the curve tool by left clicking with a mouse or touchpad. Then make a line slanted upwards here. Since we have not changed the size, it is still a thin line. You can go and change the size again to the size which you want. And now pull a little, drag it upwards like this, and then double click it so that it becomes a permanent line here. Join this one, this end to here, and then just slightly drag it inwards like this. At the bottom also, let's make a line from here going outwards, and then we need to drag it towards the front. Or if you think it's not working because it is going to overlap the line, you can just do undo, use the undo to undo this line and then draw it again from here, so that when we drag it towards the front, it does not overlap the other line which is already there. Then next, we make another line from here downwards and join it here, and then just make it curved in inwards or outwards like this. And we can actually use two curves and then double click, leave it there. If you notice that there is a big gap between the fin, you can use the line tool to just make a small line here, or you can even use the curve tool. It's better to use the line tool if the gap is big. You can just draw or join this here and ensure that there are no gaps. So this way you can make this picture of a fish using the curve tool. Can you tell what is this picture called? This is a picture of a dolphin. Now show how you will make this picture. And in case you face a problem, then watch the video being shown and learn from it. Let us now look at this video and see how we can use the curve tool to make the picture of a whale. For this, again, we will be using the curve tool. So first, take your pointer to the curve tool and select the same. Bring your pointer to the drawing area on your paint sheet and let's drag the first curve or the first line horizontally like this, as is being shown in the video. And then from the left side, keep the pointer somewhere on the line and then drag it upwards. Double click it here to get the top portion of the whale so that you get the first curve on your paint sheet. Now we drag from here, from the first point and till here, and then we can just double click here to get this line or the curve. Now we need to make the tail fins. So we take our pointer to the end point of the first curve and from here drag a line slanting upwards towards the left side and double click. Then again on the bottom side, let's drag another line slanting downwards, and from the middle just drag it like this and double click. Then we can join the two endpoints and keep the pointer in the middle and drag inwards. So this way we can make the tail fins, double click on it. Next, let us make another curve inside the whale to show its jaws and also to show its eye. So we make these lines or the curves here and drag this I curve slightly upwards. And double click. Next, we have to make the fins on the sides. So we need to use the eraser tool. Select the eraser and then just erase a little portion of the bottom line. As is being shown in the video, we just erase this portion from here and then starting from the inside of the wheel, we can make a small curve going outwards. We first have to select the curve tool again to make the side fins. Bring the pointer back and draw from inside the wheel towards the outside. And then you can put the pointer in the middle of this line and curve it slightly forward. If the line crosses the bottom line, you can select this portion and then just move it so that it looks proper. And then make another small curve here and move it slightly towards the forward and then double click there. This way, you have now completed the picture of the wheel. So this is how you can use the curve tool to make this picture of a wheel. Can you tell what is this picture called? This is a picture of a bow and arrow. Can you tell which tools have been used in making this picture? This picture has been made using a combination of the curve tool, line tool and the text tool. Make this picture and in case you face a problem, watch the video being shown. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the curve tool and the line tool to make this picture of bow and arrow. So for doing this, let's first select the line tool. First select the curve tool and make this small curve here and then just drag it upwards a little bit and then double click on it so that the first curve has been made on your paint sheet. Now select the line tool to make the tip of the arrow. You can drag from this one end like this upwards. If you don't like it, you can use undo to erase it and make it again properly. Again, from the other side, you can join the tip of the arrow like this. Now we need to make the arrow itself. So we make a line from here, from the center, downward slanting like this. And then on the sides here at the bottom, we can make these small lines like this. And here, so that the picture of the arrow is complete. Now we need to make the bow. And for that, we will be using the curve tool. So we select the curve tool, bring a pointer here and drag this first line slanting downwards towards the right and double click on it. Since we have to make the top two lines which are curved, we drag another line on top of the first curve itself and then keeping a pointer in the center, we can drag it downwards like this so that the curve is made and then click on it once with your left button. Since we want to make a double line for the top of the bow, we can make another curve again on the first line itself. Bring the pointer to the center and drag it upwards. Like this. Now we have to just make small lines. So we can select the line tool to make those lines. We select the line tool and then bring the pointer here and make these lines here on the bow itself. So we make two lines here and two more lines we'll need to make just to make it look nice. So this way you can make the picture of the bow and arrow. Look at the picture shown and say how you can make it. In order to make this picture, you will need to use curve tool, oval tool and the polygon tool. Can you tell what you will need to do if you want to make many faces from a given face? As you all already know, to make many faces from a given face, you will need to use the copy-paste option. Make this picture, and if you have a doubt, watch the video. With the help of this video, let us now learn how we can make this multiple face picture. We will use the curve tool, the oval tool, and the line tool. So first select the oval tool and drag an oval here on your paint sheet. Now we have to cut the top portion. So we need to first go to the select option and select the rectangular selection. Then bring the pointer close to the oval that you have drawn on the top and just select the top portion. And you can cut this using the shortcut command Ctrl plus X. Next, we have to draw the top of the face. So we select the line tool, bring a pointer here, and then drag a line joining the top of the oval like this. Next, we need to make the eyes. So we select the oval tool. Once again, select solid color and make color 1 and color 2 the same color. We are choosing black here. However, since we have to make a oval without color inside, we need to select color 2 as white. And again, go to fill and select no fill. And then drag this oval here. If you like, you can change the thickness by going to the size option. Next, we have selected solid fill because now we will be making a solid oval inside the eye. So we select the solid color from the fill option. Make the color 2 also black and then drag this small oval within the first oval to make the eye and the pupil of the eye. Now we need to do a copy paste. So we again go to the select tool, select the rectangular selection. Select this entire eye by making a rectangle around it, and then we can use our copy paste commands, Ctrl plus C for copy and Ctrl plus V for paste. and then pick this eye from here and bring it here. Now you see that this eye is overlapping the oval which we had made. Go to the select tool and select the rectangular transparent selection to correct this. Now you notice it's all white because make the color tool has to be made white. So once again do a control V to paste it, and this time when you pick and bring it, because now color 2 has been made white, this eye will be properly there. You have, remember, you have to select the transparent selection. Now you can drag this eye to its proper position here, like this. Next, we have to make the mustache on this face. For that, we have to select the curve tool. And then bring a pointer within the face here down and drag a first curve from here downwards, slanting towards the left like this. You can bring the pointer here and move it upwards, and then from the end of the mustache you can move it slightly down also, and then double click on it. Once again draw another curve to make the bottom side of the mustache like this, and then drag it downwards. If you don't like something, you can always use undo to erase it and then redraw it, as we are doing in this video, like this. Drag it downwards from here and drag it slightly upwards from the end, as is being shown in the video. Next, we need to fill in the color in the mustache to make it a solid black mustache. So we select the fill with option, fill with color option, and fill in the color here, the black color. Similarly, we have to make the mustache on the other side. So we again select the curve tool. Bring the pointer here and then drag it downwards, this time towards the right side. Pull it, drag it up here and drag the bottom side downwards, just like this, and double click. Then drag another curve from here to complete the other side of the mustache. Drag it a little downwards, and from the end we can drag it little upwards also, so it looks nice like this, and double click. Again fill this using the fill with color option. We select the fill with color option and fill in the color black in this part of the mustache also. Next, we have to just make the crown on this face. So we select the polygon tool this time and drag our first line here. As is being shown, from the top downwards like this, and then when we keep the pointer towards the left side, a second line gets dragged automatically, as you know in the polygon. Then we keep it here, and the third line, we bring it down here, up here, and the lines keep getting dragged on their own. And then in the end, we just join the starting point to the end point of the polygon, and the polygon is completed. Now we need to just fill color inside. So we select the fill with color option and make color 1 red. By selecting the red color, we bring the pointer inside the crown and fill in the color here. Now the picture of the face is complete. We just need to make copies and paste them. So we first use the select tool, select the rectangular selection. If you click on the select tool, it is by default rectangular selection. So you can just select it, select the face, and then use copy paste. Ctrl plus C to copy and Ctrl plus V to paste, and then drag this face, second face here. If by chance this face overlaps on the first face, remember that in the selection option, you should select the transparent selection, and that will not happen. Again, do a Ctrl V and then drag this third face also here, and similarly by doing paste again and again, we can drag two more faces as is being shown in the video, and then get the copy and then bring it here by dragging. One more time, use Ctrl V, Ctrl plus V for paste, and drag it down here like this. So all the pictures with the five faces with the crown, funny looking picture, is ready. So this is how we can use to make the faces. Since we will end today's class now, save your paint file and shut down your computer. In today's class, you practiced using the curve tool and used it to make many pictures like a scenery, fish, dolphin, bow and arrow, and some other drawings. Computer Shiksha is supported by... Thank you.